I said it. What other races in the United States call each other their racial slang, their racial epithets? I have never, I'm going to use a racial slur for someone that's Italian. Let's say a racial slur would be a tally, correct? I have never heard another Italian person say, "What's up, tally? Hey, tally, give me some dab. What's going on?" I've never heard that. Y'all heard it?
Well, not Italian.
I said
not Italian, but like
Spanish,
like white. Yeah,
I've heard. You heard other races?
Yeah. My mom and brother are Mexicans.
So, do you think that people have tried to change that word to mean something different?
Yeah. They try to change it with like a homie slang, right? That's, yeah. That's what some
people. Okay. Do you think that it sounds educated when you say it?
Well, you know when to use it. Like, yeah.
When you know when to use it. So when's a good time to use it?
When you're chilling. You in your own house.
I guess.
Yeah, when you're in your own house.
Yeah, when you, I'm not going to be out in the streets and I'm at a job interview or something. Like, hey, what up?
Yeah.
You know, that's not
as
good.
Right.
Okay. Not at a place of profession.
Not a place in profession? Okay. But it's okay to say it when you go to Walmart.
I mean, it's not okay.
Do you say it at Walmart?
No.
Walmart?
You said it at Walmart.
I told you I said it at Walmart. I told you I said it at Walmart. I said, listen, I was with a group of friends, and this when I was a little bit younger. I was still in college. I was bored. I went to go play with some of the toys because I had nothing else to do. And I said the N-word with the GA at the end to my other friends. I said, hey, nigga, come here. And somebody looked at me down the aisle. And I felt like too small. I was like, wow, you look real educated right now. You look real classy. Can't believe you just said that. My friends were like, dang, you said that loud. You said that, he said that real loud. Like he was meaning it or something. And I wasn't even meaning it. I just wanted to come here, so I could have said come here. You know what I mean? I could have said come here. But at that time, I didn't know any better. I know better now. And if I was to say it, if me and Mr. Jason was to say it in our house, and my son said it, what kind of parent would I look like? If my son is just walking around, just saying.
What
kind of parent would I look like?
Because he wouldn't
know how to do it.
Look like
you
have no structure.
Right.
No structure in my household.
Race.
Okay, go ahead.
A bad word, like, as y'all said, maybe. Uh-huh. What makes a word a bad word?
You're exactly right. I think how you say it makes a bad word. I think where it came from makes a bad word. And I think how you use it towards others makes it a bad word.
It's just like,
all right, good. If I say good, so if I say good, that makes it bad.
Clap, what's that called? How you say good? Tone. Okay? Your tone, how you say it, you sound like you're saying it angry.
Sarcastic.
Right?
It's just like,
no, I'm not. I'm confused.
So your name is Kenny, right?
Yes.
So come down here, Kenny. Yes, I do call you out. And I call you out so you can participate and not just sit in your seats. All right, Kenny. My class knows that we practice tone. And so I'm gonna have Kenny do tone. Oh, you gotta hear that. You wasn't sounding too deep up there. You're sick. So I want you to say good and angry in this microphone so they can hear. So it exemplifies my voice. Well, I want you to add that.
Maybe good.
Did y'all see how he curled his lip? Yeah. He like, good. Now say it happy. Walk a little closer, please.
Good.
He said, good. Now, would you say it's sad?
Don't cry.
know what I'm saying? Like, whenever they gave the word N-I-G-G-R definition, and it became known as an ignorant person. You can look in a dictionary, and that's what the definition is. You can say, I am not that N-I-G-G-E-R word, okay? So, my friends, if they say it to me in that form, I might look at them a little cross-eyed, like, what did you just say? But then, throughout history, we've tried to change it to make it seem a little bit better. So we took the E-R off, and we put the G-A on, so that it would be kind of like, you're my friend, hey, what's up, all that kind of stuff. And it's in all the music that some of us choose to listen to as well. And then, you remember on CNN, I think, what was it, maybe about 2 years ago, when they tried to bury the word? And who was the comedian on there? Was that the crazy cowboy? Yeah. He had a noose around his neck because he was protesting. So I think for you, Kenny, whatever makes you feel like the word is negative is going to be what makes you feel the word is negative. And how you say it to other people, if you say it angry, they're going to see whether or not you're angry when you say it. If you're saying it to one of your teammates or whatever, they may not think of it that way because you may be saying it in a calm voice. But you also have to be aware of your surroundings and who else hears you and what they think about when you say that word. Does that make it help you out a little bit better?
Yeah, of course it does. I mean, it's obviously not the obvious answer. It's just different from when I come to think about it. I just don't understand that.
Sometimes it's crazy. I mean, say for example, we were talking.
You said where the word nigga came from. Mm-hmm. You said from
Nigeria.
Like, who said that? How much of a fact is that?
That's a big fact. If you go back to look when where the slave ships came from, what part of Africa they were coming from, majority of them were coming from Nigeria. So they had tags written on them that said Nigeria, and so they couldn't pronounce it right. So then there is also a place in Africa, am I correct? Called N-I-G-E-R in Africa, correct? Okay? Yes, there is. It is. Look on the maps.
So basically, we made the word bad.
Basically, no, you didn't make the word bad. That was your origin of where you was coming from. And so the other individuals decided to make the word bad. Sometimes if people don't have a word to call you to make sense, then they're just going to make up some word. They're just going to call you some name. Like in class, I had some of my students say that the V word is a word they don't like. And I surprised them and I said, I like that word. I think it's a compliment. Then I say, I think it's a compliment. I work hard for that title, you know. But they asked me, well, how would you get mad? Well, how would you get mad at that? And I said, like, Mr. Jason called me that. I was, you know, he was a little mad. He called me that. He gonna call me that, I mean. But if Mr. Jason called me that, I'd be mad. If one of my girls called me, depending on how the situation was.
Right.
No, I necessarily wouldn't be mad. But, you know, Siobhan had a little saying that technically the B word is a female dog, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so in some cases it may not be used as a curse word. In some cases it could be used as a curse word. And it could be derogatory as well. If someone's rapping in a song or singing rock and roll in a song or whatever else, and they refer to all females as that in some type of derogatory manner, then yes, that word becomes bad and people will not want to be associated with that. But however, if they say that word means that you're a confident, independent woman, educated, and that you're about your stuff and you don't need a man to take care of you, then yes, I want that word. Do you understand the difference?
You know why they didn't go through the CNN? Yes. It don't matter how many times you sit here and you try to ban a word. If, like, just like tonight, you can sit here and try to talk about the word, get it? When this is over, it doesn't matter. When we go out, we might walk down the road. Nigga, I'm on you. That's
right. But I'm not here tonight to change the way that you talk. See, the one thing that I did was I got Kenny to think something different than what he was thinking before. So sometimes you don't automatically get to see the change when you're speaking to people, when you're teaching people, you don't automatically get to see the change. You know, sometimes you gotta wait years and years and years before you see the change. But I gotta have him come down here and ask me a question that he wasn't sure about. And so that means more to me than whether or not all of you go back and say it or don't say it. But it's gonna take a little bit to change it. It's gonna take a lot more to keep the change going. You see what I'm saying? Now this is not just a presentation for for light-skinned black individuals and dark-skinned black individuals. This is us saying thank you for being part of history. Thank you for helping us. You know, for those of you who have been abolitionists back in the day, thank you for taking that support in that time to make sure that we made it, that we got to where we needed to go, that you were part of a government system that passed laws that we had no control over. Because if I ask the question, and they're your friends, and I think they would be honest, how many of you would be slave owners? I think they would be true. How many of you would not be slave owners? Now, what would happen if her slaves got caught reading and writing?
She'll get in trouble. Not on my part.
She'll die. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they would burn all the time.
Because let me tell you something. When somebody knows something, they say, you know, you ever heard, don't tell nobody?
Yeah.
Don't tell nobody. They always have somebody else that they tell. So if you're teaching me how to read, then I'm going to teach my friend how to read. And then my friend's going to teach them how to read. And then how to read, hey, where did you learn that from? Miss Teresa's farm. And so then people would just run to you. You would be in more danger than your slaves would be in danger because of what your power is. Your power is education. See, money is just a monetary value. Okay, it can be taken from, you got $5, I can take it out your pocket. Some of you are like, yeah, right, try. I try hard enough. I have weapons. I can take it. You'll give it to me. I bet you would. Put a gun in your head and you can try that. Your life is more important than $5. I hope you give it up. You give it to me? You understand what I'm saying? That's a blessing that they're able to give to somebody else, but that gives them power that other people don't necessarily want them to have. So I think it's a good idea, a great idea, and I would hope that if you was back in that day, you would do that. Basketball. What's his name? Yin?
Jeremy
Wynn. I do know a little bit of something. Mr. Jason keeps Sports Center on nonstop. So I have to like listen a little bit, seem a little educated on that. But you're totally right. If she could have influenced the people that she was with to tell them that they were not slaves, they would not be enslaved. John, if I looked at you and said to your daddy, possibly, or your grandparents, wanted you to do whatever it is that they wanted to do, and you said, I'm not going to do that, do you think that you would have been able to get by with that back in the day? You don't think so? Chance, what you think? You would have kind of had to be forced in the daughter? And see, that's what happens sometimes. Generations, even though they're younger, you're forced into certain things. Want you to listen to this song one more time. We'll have a brief discussion, and y'all go. Because it's your your history. It's not just black history, it's your history. It's what made you be able to come and play whatever type of sports you're playing. It's what been able to make you come to class and pick whatever studies you want to study. It's made you be able to leave Cleveland. Where else? Florida.
Michigan.
Where? Michigan. Anybody from Michigan? Virginia. Dominican Republic.
She's from Hagerstown.
Hagerstown. We talked about that. Just as long as you don't go down Jonathan Street, you're good. Okay? We talked about it from here with that. So now to take questions and answers. I didn't introduce myself before I came in because I wanted the presentation to be about y'all. My name is Miss Amber, and some of you have had me in class teaching criminal justice, and I teach the business or the technical writing class. I work at the Day Report Center as a counselor, as well during the daytime, so I've had some of you come to class. So I heard some of you stand up and say, are we going to have to take all everything out of our pockets? But this right here is my passion, speaking in front of individuals. It's my passion. I feel that it's a gift that I've been given, and it's something that I enjoy. I don't feel like I'm working when I'm doing it. And so I appreciate you letting me come to you today and talk to you and share my gift. I practiced last night with my son's microphone, so Mr. Jason was trying to say I sound like a preacher. I said, hey, Mr. Jason, we'll be in the chapel, so if something comes over me, it's not my fault. So I'm just going to let it come out however it comes out. But I want you to know that some of the material that I went over tonight wasn't just to make you think or make you go Google something or make you understand it, but I wanted you to realize that all of you are part of history regardless if you want to be a part of history. Regardless of what section you ended up sitting in or what section you ended up moving to, you have choices. And that's the only difference about us now and those before, is they didn't have choices because they weren't educated enough to have those choices, or they didn't know what choices it was they should have chose. And so when I have a student that comes to me and says, you know, I'm having issues or I'm having problems, and I can sit and talk to them and say, your son is more important than anything else in this world, and you make sure that he understands that your education is going to make him be a better man. See, those type of phrases that I'm able to have with my students, those are priceless. You can't get those back. You have to think of stuff that you can't get back. Okay, we've been in here now for, it's 7:39. We can't get none of that time back. It's all gone. That's history. What happened yesterday? Ever came to class? We didn't have to go to class. Some of us came, some of us didn't come. We learned some things, we did learn some things. That was the history for today, Monday, 2012, February the 20th. Tomorrow, it may matter, it may not matter. You may go out here making some changes, you may not make no changes. But I feel that there's been somewhat of change made in the room because questions have been asked. I'm going to take a couple questions and then I'm going to end it. Anybody have anything out that they want to discuss, they want to talk about, that didn't get brought up? No questions? Adam, you good? I also like to thank my extra credit volunteers, James, with the lighting and the paper bag, Adam with the skeleton and the CD player, Robert, Oscar, I don't know where, I think he disappeared. Well, there you are. Brittany passing out tickets. Yes, ma'am.
Why do you think when you said move where y'all want to move, ain't nobody move?
Because I think once you get comfortable, you get complacent, you got comfortable in your chair, it might got warm for you, your feet got crossed, you might as well just sit right where I'm sitting at.
You don't think it has nothing to do with the surrounding and the people you hang out with?
No. Because this is what you have to understand. These people that right now you're with, this is your support system. But when you leave, you're going to have a completely different support system. Go ahead and stand up for me, Alan. Alan is from Cleveland. Okay, you said you used to play basketball, right?
Yeah.
So you can still go talk to some basketball players if you want to, right?
Yeah.
Okay. But where is Cleveland at? Where's Cleveland at in Salem, West Virginia? We had this conversation the other day about people that have your back, right? Siobhan, you remember?
Right here.
People that have your back.
I'm Cleveland.
That's your brother? Mm-hmm. So, your brother? Mm-hmm. That's, I would pick one more if I knew you was Alan's brother. But, so you have a support system, you have your brother, so why don't you come down here and stand by your brother? Can I get one other person that supports Alan?
With a love.
Of course,
yeah. That's what I'm talking about. With a love.
Me too. I just talked like
you. Yeah, I know what you're
saying.
Oh,
what are they going to do?
Right.
We're
Cleveland.
I got your back.
All right, so those that support Alan, I want you to get in front of him and lock arms. Now it's nice that he knows that he has a support system because they got him. So no matter what, he knows that he can go to these individuals and they got him. That's his chance, that's his change that he's gonna make, that he has a support system. Try to go through him, Alan. Because everything in front of them is negative. You understand? Everything in front of them is negative. Everything in front of them is negative. Try to get through him, Alan. They ain't let nobody get through him because they're his support system. They're supposed to be his support system. Now, when she has to go back to Hagstown, when you go back to Cleveland, when you said, I'm standing, I'm there. Kareem, when you gotta go back to Germany, right? You still got a couple people, right, that supports you. There's some space over here, and there's some space over here, but these are his teachers. These are his teachers, his principals, his teachers. These are his teachers. And maybe they got to spread out a little bit harder. Maybe they got to hold a little bit tighter, but he still has a support system. You don't let your brother down.
Not at all.
Okay? And you're going to be all right, Kevin. Alan, Kevin must be talking about me, whoever he is. I don't know if they Alan or Kevin.
brother.
I was playing. But do you understand that Alan has a support system? You got to know who your support system are. There was a lot more people that was trying to get up and support you. But I only asked for a few. You said Miss Deb said she hates seeing you be on a certain list. She's not mentioning any names, but she's a support system. And Mr. Jason, he's a support system. And Miss Sarah is a support system. And these other professors that are sitting here in front of our support system.
Pardon me?
I'm sorry, what was your name
again? Lori
McCallum. Miss Lori is a support system. She brings speakers into your classroom so that you can understand a little bit better, so that you don't have to sit and read a book and get bored. Siobhan, what's your friend's name?
Jackie.
Jackie?
Jackie.
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 Babyface.
Jackie. Okay. Like 227 Jackie? Okay, Jackie, come down here. This is the last time we're going to do the senior unless y'all have any questions. I just want you to turn and face the crowd. I'm asking all the females tonight. I'm sorry, Chad Goku is somewhere yesterday. I'm definitely sorry. Like Ms. Deb said, they're ignorant individuals. Okay, so what I want every female to do is if you've been through something, stand up. If you got over something, stand up. If you're going through something, you know you're going to get over something, stand up. Okay? And what I want you to do is I want you to come down and place your hand on Jack A. Not a face. Just get around him. But wait for him to come down. Do you see all the support on this? I know. All right, ladies, let's get a moment of silence. Jack K. Woo! Like 227 Jack K. Last night, had an experience in Subway, which was not too good. You gotta close your eyes. We in church. If you go to another place, just let yourself go. It's all right. All these women who have been through something, who's going through something, who got over something, don't fake now, Brittany. I'm going to move out of the way if the roller coaster comes after you. What I want y'all to see, I want you ladies to be quiet, is that you all here that are putting your hands on Jack A are supporting her in a way that you don't even know. That she won't have to experience what she experienced last night. And then whoever was with her is going to have to experience what she experienced last night, because what you're doing right now is you're letting her know that you've had pain. That you've had pain. And that you've been through some things, and that you've gone through some things that she doesn't have to go through because you're going to go through it for her. Y'all can have a seat. Y'all can stop playing in the chat. We don't want no fake shouting, no fake hollering, anything like that. If you felt something that was good, then I just want to let you know that all these ladies here, they're supporting you. You gotta have a support system. Sometimes in life, you don't have a support system till you're older. You understand that? You guys are college students. You have a whole college of faculty members that are going to support you. You have a whole dorm room of students that are going to support you. And if you feel like you need that support without going to five or six people, that you just need to go to one person and get that support, you can. Y'all contact me if you need anything for support. But once again, thank you guys for letting me come tonight. Any other questions or concerns? Adam? Number one, I heard speaking in tongues. Yeah. All right. Easy with that. All right. You guys, thank you for coming out. You have a great evening. For those of you in my class, I'll see y'all.